Today topic is called document type and number ranges. Document type and number ranges. First of all, you people want to understand what is meant by document type. Document type means what? Can anyone should respond? What is meant by document type? I will tell you. Okay. Are you able to hear my voice? Yes, right? The very simple manner, I will tell you. The non-SAP, we are called accounting entry. Okay. In the SAP, we are called as a document entry. Right? I will tell you one thing. Non-SAP, we are called as a accounting entry. Right? In the SAP, what we called? Document entry. Document entry. Okay. In the non-SAP, we are called accounting type. SAP, we are called document type. Very simple. What is meant by accounting type? Accounting entry type means this accounting entry belongs to which accounting entry, is this vendor accounting entry or is this customer accounting entry or is this GL accounting entry, is this asset accounting entry or is this invoice or is this payment, which type? Got it my point? What is meant by document entry? Non-SAP we are called as a accounting entry type. Means is this invoice or payment? What type? What is meant by type? Type means what? Means very simple manner I will explain you. Okay. What is meant by type? Type means is this customer invoice or vendor invoice or GL postings? Or customer payment, which type of accounting entry? Or vendor payment, which type of accounting entry is this? Document type means, everyone note it down one note, everyone please note it down one note. Document type is classify the accounting entry. Very simple. What is meant by document entry? Document type means classify the accounting entry. Example, you can note it down. This is the examples, you can note it down examples. This one. Example, customer invoice posting, vendor invoice posting, GL posting. Customer payment posting, vendor payment posting, like that. Document type is classify the accounting entry. Done? Hey, are you able to hear my voice or not? Yes or no, anything, anyone should respond, please.
Yes, Venkat.
Yeah, thank you. See this one. For example, I will give you one more example. In one report, example, let's take one bucket. In one bucket, I have 1000 accounting entries in one bucket. Let's imagine there is one bucket. Under that bucket, we have 1000 accounting entries. 1000 accounting entries. So I want to know how many have customer invoice posting, how many have vendor invoice posting, how many have GL postings, how many have asset postings. How to find out that? If you want to find out every accounting entry you want to open, and let's see, is this customer posting or vendor posting? Every accounting entry you want to open and see. So it will take a lot of time. If I open every accounting entry, it will take a lot of time. So SAP has given one solution. SAP has defined 58 standard document type. 58 standard document types. 58 standard document type. Standard document type. 58 standard document type. What is that? Example, let's see here. Everyone, let's see here. Whatever document have SA, that is called GL accounting entry posting. Whatever accounting entry have DR, that is called customer invoice posting. This is the solution. SAP has given 58 standard document types. Example, whatever accounting entry have KR document type, standard. This is the standard KR document type, that is called vendor invoice posting. Then example, DZ is called customer payment. And whatever accounting entry have KZ document type, KZ, that is called vendor payment posting. Okay, not need to open every document. Let's see the document types, standard document types. How many standard document types is there? 58 standard document types is there. Example, whatever accounting entry or whatever document entry have DR, that is called customer invoice. Whatever have KR, vendor invoice, SA, GL postings, and DZ, customer payment, and KZ, vendor payment, like that. Then it is easy to identify this accounting entry belongs to which type. If you go to the document type identification, easy identification. This accounting entry belongs to which type? This document type. Document type means which type of document type? Means DR, KR, SA, DZ, KZ. Example I said 5. Standard, how many standard types? 58. Note it down. Note. We have 58 standard document types. We have 58 standard document types. If you want to create your own, then it is possible. Not like that. One second. I will tell you. You are easy to understand. You just throw that word. SAP has provided, you can write it this way. Note. SAP has provided 58 standard document type. 58 standard document types. Example, you can note it down this again. Faster, I'm giving only 1 minute. Example, you can note it down this again. DR, customer invoice. Suresh, are you following? Note it down fast. Done? Yeah. See this one. 58 standard document type. If you want to use standard, next one, next line. If you want to use standard, if you want to use standard, you can use. If you want to use standard, you can use. Otherwise, you can create your own document types. Otherwise, you can create your own document types. You can create your own document types. You can create your own document types. Done? Yeah. Example, let's see here. Example, what is meant by SA? What is meant by SA? Just now I tell you, na. SA means GL accounting entry posting. Accounting entry posting. Okay. GL accounting entry posting. Listen carefully. I'm explaining about number range. And based on this document type, I created one number range. One second. Based on document type, I created one number range. What is that number range? Example, I created 1 to 100. And one more document type. DR. What is meant by DR? Customer invoice indeed. DR means customer invoice posting. So based on this DR, I created one more number range, 1012 and 200. This number to this number. I created this number. Okay, everyone, listen careful. If I post customer invoice, which number should be reflected? Example, 101. Again, one more customer invoice I posted. Again, 102. Again, I posted one more customer invoice, 103. If you post any accounting entry, system will generate one number range based on your number ranges. If you post any accounting entry, system will generate the number based on your number ranges. For example, now I posted GL accounting entry. So which number will should reflect? 1. Again I posted GL accounting entry posting. 2. Again I posted GL accounting entry posting. 3. Now I posted customer invoice. Which number should be reflected? Now I posted customer invoice. 104. Very good. 104. Like that. So based on the document type, we need to generate one number ranges. Based on this number ranges, if you post any accounting entry, the number should be reflected. Anyone understood or not? Any doubts? Clear, na? Very good. See this one. I will tell you one thing. If you post any accounting entry is, it may be customer, vendor, GL, asset, how many currencies should be reflected? Three currencies. What is that? Very good. Local currency, group currency, and transactional currency. How many ledgers should reflected? How many types of ledgers reflected? Two types of ledgers should be reflected. What is that? Leading ledger. Okay, very good. Non-leading. Okay, leading ledger and non-leading ledger. See this one. I will tell you one thing. If you post any accounting entry, two types of views. What is meant by view? Let's see. View. Two types of views generated. What is that? One is entry view and GL view. See this one. What is meant by entry view and what is meant by general ledger view? I will tell you at the time of accounting entry postings. Okay. So better you can note it down, this local currency and group currency and transactional currency. Three types of currencies and two types of ledgers, leading ledger and non-leading ledger, and two types of views. If you post one accounting entry, this much of information should reflect it. Please note it down fast. I will give you only 1 minute. Done?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yes. Nav. So what is meant? The interviewer will ask the question. What is meant by document type and what is meant by number ranges? Document type means it is classify the accounting entries or it is classify the documents. SAPs provide 58 standard document types is there. Based on the document type, we are generating one number ranges. That number ranges should reflected on when you post accounting entry. Okay. Like this you want to. Let's start for configuration. GL document type and number ranges. Document type and number ranges. everyone, let's see the configuration. Be careful, okay? Define document type for entry view. I said you na. What is the difference between entry view and ledger view? If you post any accounting entry, two types of views should be reflected. One is entry view, one is general ledger view. Okay, the first one. Define document type for entry view. Define document type for entry view. Let's check the document types. Go to SPRO. Go to SPRO. Everyone, are you able to follow?
Yes, sir.
I'm start for the configuration. Define document type for the entry view. So SPRO, financial accounting new, financial accounting global settings new, document and document type. Document and document type. What is the T code? OBA7, the standard T code actually. OBA7. See here. Go to SAP. Everyone, listen carefully. Go to SAP. SPRO. Enter. SAP reference IMG. Select here financial accounting new, financial accounting global settings new, and documents or document, and the first one document type and second one is number ranges. The first one is called document type, the second one is called number ranges. So the first one you can select document type. Under document type, the first one, define document type for entry view. Define document type for entry view. And click on your additional information. Additional information. Display keys IMG activates. Let's check the T code. What is the T code? The last four digit is the T code. OBA7. OBA7 is the T code. Sorry?
I'm not able to see your screen.
Who is he?
Screen for the slow down. I could hear maybe explain this screen later.
Okay, one second. Do one thing. Everyone should join again. Better. Okay. Yes, now I'm starting the configuration. I'm starting the configuration of document types and number ranges. Now, what is the path? I'm repeating once again. Like SPRO, financial accounting new, financial accounting global settings new, document and document type. Document and document type. Let's see here. Everyone, SPRO, enter, SAP reference IMG, select here financial accounting new, financial accounting global settings, I'm repeating once again, SPRO, enter, SAP reference IMG, select here financial accounting new and financial accounting global settings, select here documents. See here, we have first one is document type, the next one is number ranges. Document type and document number ranges. Okay, and first one you just select the document type. Again, first one, define document type for entry view. And what is the T code? How to see the T code? Go to additional information, display keys and IMG activities. What is the T code? the last four digit OBA7 is the T code. Everyone are able to see my screen?
Yes, Venkat.
Yeah, the last four digit is the T code OBA7. You just double click on this document type. Example, if you want to understand more information, what is meant by document type, you just double click on this document. Okay, if you just double click on this document, the SAP will explain more and more information. What is meant by document type, why document type, when document type, it's provide all the information. Okay, then just go through that information if you required. Okay, then if you want to check the document type, you just double click on this timer. You just double click on this timer and see here. Example, see here, what is meant by DR? DR, customer invoice. See here, DR, customer invoice. And click on your position, SA, press enter. What is meant by SA? GL account document. And click on your position and KR. What is the KR? Vendor invoice. KR is vendor invoice. And click on your position and KZ. KZ is here only. KZ, vendor payment. Vendor payment. And click on your position DZ. What is the DZ? Customer payment. So how many standard document types is there? 58 standard document types is there. Example, see here, example, click on your position, SA, enter, select SA, click on your position, click on your display, select SA, click on display. You just click on your display. See here, the information will come like this. SA means GL accounting document. Enter here any two digit, only for the numerical. Enter here any two digit. Based on this two digit, I want to create one number ranges from this number to this number. I want to create one number ranges. Okay. And reversal document type AB. See everyone, listen carefully. If I post GL accounting entry posting, SA should be reflected. If I reverse that document type, if I reverse that accounting entry, AB should be reflected. AB should be reflected. Then this SA allowed for the negative postings and intercompany postings also. Okay, then go back. If you want to create one, if you want to create new document type, what will you do? Click on your new entry, then you can create your own document type. Enter your any two digits, then number range, reversal document type, and how many types of accounts should be allowed, negative posting allowed or not, and intercompany posting allowed not. Then you can select the radio button, suitable radio buttons. Then go back and write the description if you want to create your own. Basically, for the practice purpose, not required to create new one, just use for the standard ones. Okay, how many standard document types is there? Can anyone? 58. Yes. Very good. Example, let's hear. Position, SA, enter. This is the SA. And click on your position, AB. What is mean by AB? Reversal, accounting document. Then click on your display, 02, and AB, accounting document. Then back. So you not need to change anything here. Just check it out. All the document types is there or not. Not required to do anything here. Okay. This is the standard one. just check the two digits of number range. That's it. Which number range should assigned here? Which number range is assigned here? SA01. Based on this 01, I want to create the number range. So for that purpose, just you can check the number range. Everything should standard. You don't want to change anything. Okay. See here. The third one. What is the third one? Define document type for the general ledger view. Define document type for the general ledger view. If you post any accounting entry, how many views generated? Two views, right? One is entry view, one is GL view, general ledger view.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Then you just double click on here. What it is asking? Ledger. Ledger means, what is our ledger? I created our own ledger, right? What is our ledger? I1. I1 means what? I1, right? I1 for IFRS. Click on your I1, then click on your new entry. SA98 and AB98. You want to ask the question, sir, the entry view is the 01. Why you entered here 98? Okay, there I showed 01, right? Anyone should respond. There I shown as a 01. Why I want to enter 98 here? Listen careful. Listen here. I will tell you one thing. Here now. Here I explained one thing. What is that? If you post any accounting entry, two types of ledgers should be reflected now. One is leading ledger and one is non-leading ledger. Sometimes I want to post only non-leading ledger. Maybe I1 or maybe I2. I want to post only non-leading ledger. So that time this 98 should be reflected in the I3. What is the leading ledger? Leading ledger is the 0L, right? Non-leading ledger is the I1 for IFRS, I2 for US GAAP. Sometimes I want to post only I1 reflection. Maybe some situation will come. Okay, that time this 98 should be reflected. Okay. Got it my point? Then click on your save and back. The 98 is the standard one. You can maintain only 98. Huh? The system will not allow other number ranges. 98 and 99 only reflect. Then click on your save. Then back. Again, double click on define document type for general ledger view. We have one more non-leading ledger, right? What is that? I2. Then click on your OK. Then click on your new entry. SA99, AB99. Why I want to enter 99? Very good. Fast reply. Sometimes I want to post only I2. If you post any accounting entry, it will be reflected 0L, I1 and I2. I don't want to reflect leading and non-leading. I want to reflect only I2. So that time this 99 should be reflected. I will show you. Future, I will show you. I want to post only non-leading ledgers. That time 99 should be reflected. then press enter and save. Okay, entry view and general ledger view. And what is this? Can anyone read this? Rajshekar, read this step. అది జనరల్ లెడ్జర్ అని ఉంది అక్కడ. సీ దిస్ వన్, లిజన్ కేర్ఫుల్. డిఫైన్ డాక్యుమెంట్ టైప్ ఫర్ ఎంట్రీ వ్యూ ఇన్ ఎ లెడ్జర్. షూర్, యు సేడ్ ఎంట్రీ వ్యూ, లెడ్జర్ వ్యూ. సో యూ క్రియేటెడ్ ఎంట్రీ వ్యూ అండ్ లెడ్జర్ వ్యూ. దట్స్ ఎనఫ్. వై ఇస్ దేర్ అగైన్ ఎంట్రీ వ్యూ, జిఎల్ వ్యూ ఇస్ ఎనఫ్. Okay, why ledger view? Everyone listen carefully. If you post any accounting entry, two types of view should be reflected. One is entry view, one is GL view. So I did both. Entry view and general ledger view. GL means general ledger view. Then one more option is here. Define document type for entry view in a ledger. Not general ledger. Why it should be reflected? You people note it down. You can see this, you can write this way. My keyboard is not working properly. If you are maintain different financial year of leading ledger and non-leading ledger. Means example, leading ledger Jan to December, non-leading ledger April to March. So there is a difference na. If you are maintain difference financial year of leading ledger and non-leading ledger, that time number ranges reflect on defined document type for entry view in a ledger. Don't confuse her. Different financial year of leading ledger and non-leading ledger, that time number range reflect on document type for entry view in a ledger. Done?
Yes, Venkat.
Yeah. See this one. Then let's listen careful. Whatever activity you did in the general ledger view, same activity you want to do for the ledger view. I am repeating once again, whatever activity you did from the general ledger view, same activity you want to do for the ledger view. So you just double click on here. Then what is meant by I1? What is meant by I1?
IFRS.
Very good. See here?
IFRS.
Very good. Very good. A non-leading ledger for IFRS. I1. Then click on your OK. Then click on your new entry. Whatever activity did there, same activity you want to do here. SA. SA 98 and AB 98. Press enter. Then click on your save. Click on your save. Go back. Go back. Again, double click on this. Now I2, right? I2. Non-leading ledger for US GAAP. Click on your OK, then new entry, SA 99, AB 99, press enter and save. Understood? Any doubts? Entry view, ledger view, general ledger view. Anyone? Any doubts? Yeah, now start with the document number ranges. I'm repeating once again, the document types is done. Let's start with number ranges. So go to SPRO, enter SAP reference IMG, select here financial accounting new, financial accounting global settings new, and documents. The first one is called document types. Under document type, we have three steps. Okay. Then the next one is called document number ranges. Then click on your this. See this one. One is document in entry view, one is documents in general ledger view. How many views it should reflected? Document in entry view, document in general ledger view. Two types of views should be reflected if you post any accounting entry. Okay, then first one, go to entry view. The first one, define document number range for entry view. Define document number range for entry view. Then you just double click on this. What is your company code? Can anyone? IG10. Then click on your change intervals. Zero 01. Did you remember 01? 01. Yeah. And what is our financial year? 2020. Okay. Now the 01 0002 010999. This is for SA document type. Number range. Example, in the Excel I said 1 to 100, 101 to 200, I said, but here I am taking 10002 109999, like that. Understood? Na? Then click on your next, add one more 02 fiscal year 2020, 02000 and 020999. When this number range should be reflected? If you reflect all the ledger, leading ledgers and non-leading ledgers. Press enter and save. and save. And if you want to reflect only IFRS, which number range I want to create? 98 2020 and 98000 to 98 0999. This number range should be reflected if you post only IFRS. Okay, then one more, what is that? US GAAP. Very good. 99 2020 99 0000 99 0999. Press enter and save and back. Then go back. This is for the IG10. I have one more company code, right? What is that?
IG20.
Do one thing. Go back again. This is defined document number range for entry view for IG10 company code. What is the second step? Copy to company code. You just double click on this timer, then click on your OK. And what is this? General selection. Oh, what is this? Copy to company code. And fiscal year 2020, source of company code IG10 means whatever number ranges you created IG10, same number ranges I want to copy to IG20. Okay, got it my point. IG10 to IG20, then click on here, execute. See here, IG20 01 02 98 99, fiscal year 2020. Okay, click on your back. Understood na? Copy to fiscal year. That number ranges I created 2020, right? I want to copy to 2020 to 2021. Okay, this option I will explain later. Copy to fiscal year. Now you, this two is enough. Okay, copy to fiscal year. I will tell you year end activities that time. And next one, what is this? Document type for general ledger view. This is entry view. In the entry view, define document number range in entry view, copy to company code. And general ledger view, first one, define document number range for general ledger view. You just double click on here. What is our company code? IG10. And click on your change intervals, 01 2020, and 01 000 and 01 09999. Then click on your add again, 02 2020 and 02 000 and 02 0999. Press enter, then again add 98 2020 98 000 and 98 0999. Then add again, then 99 2020 99 000 99 0999. Press enter, then click on your save and back. Then go back. The next, copy to company code. Then double click on here. Enter here your fiscal year 2020. And whatever number ranges I created, IG10, same number ranges I want to copy to IG20, right?
Then click on your execute. Yes. Save and back. So this is entry view and ledger view, both views. And here also copy to fiscal year. That one I will explain you later. Why confuse here? So this is the document types and number ranges. Any doubts? Anyone? Any doubts? Anyone? అరే ఎనీ వన్ అంటే ఎవరో ఒకరు రెస్పాండ్ అవ్వండి అని.